This is Jampas with Zola.
Doesn't matter what happens in the world, when I go to the studio, I'm free there.
Yeah.
Do you get the same feeling?
Yeah. Yeah. Most definitely. Like, even if I can stay there for 3 days or whatever, it's fine.
Just and the managers must understand, bring good chicken and good whiskey. We can stay in the studio for 3 days, turn off the phone. So one of the loved ones must have one.
Yeah.
And then, oh, you got 10 tracks.
Nah, 20 on the 20? Album.
Yeah. Are you
20
mad?
Tracks?
Yeah, 20 songs on the album.
Jeez.
You know that's a double album these days. Like these days, people release 9 yana.
Hey, I started working on the album last year, so we had like 50 songs to choose from.
Oh yeah, 50. Oh yeah.
Yeah, so like there's like, we had to, you know, cut out some songs and we're left with the 20.
Mina, if I die, I'm leaving you enough separate so that you guys can remix me for the next 10 years.
Yeah.
Songs that are just packed there. Ngiyasibeka because I don't know, you know, that thing. But you don't know when you're going to die.
Yeah.
So you just keep songs there and you record every day. You just stash them. Some are relevant. Some will be relevant in 10 years' time. So you kind of like function like that.
Yeah, most definitely. I just keep making music. Even if I have enough or whatever, I just keep going.
I just wish most musicians would know that a studio is a permanent hangout place.
Yeah. Really cool. A lot of people think... Is he just a junkie there, whatever, you know? Yo, man, he's cooking up hits up in there.
There's no studio session, man. The studio is home.
Yeah.
So what is this album called, the new one?
This album right here is called Manando. I named it after a big homie of mine who I went to school with. He was my senior.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was like... See, me growing up, I was bullied a lot, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And so he was like... defending me all the time, you know, standing up for me. He was not only doing that for me, but, you know, other kids in the neighborhood as well.
Yeah.
You know, so, yeah, he got murdered, he got killed in 2014.
Oh, okay.
You know, yeah, he was like Chuck Norris. Like, so
that's a cut.
Yeah, so they had to, like, just shoot him countless times.
Yeah.
That was the... Because, like, even if you came as a group, he was a one-man gang man.
Mm-hmm,
all
mm-hmm.
the stuff you see in movies of, like, Chuck
Norris... He did it on his own.
Not being touched. And all that stuff. Yeah, he did all that.
I'm sure his email address was gmail@manando.com.
Yeah,
so tough he was.
Yeah.
I hope when you shoot your video, maybe you get a couple of his pics so we can see the man on TV.
Yeah.
Because original, because people don't know that.
My home of origin, but I was raised in Joburg, I've lived in Soweto with my aunt here, White City.
Yeah,
just across the Jababu Stadium.
Yeah.
I've also lived in Matatiel, you know, for like 3-4 years of my life, did my grade 1, 2, and so forth. And I came to complete my primary here at Jews.
Yeah.
You know, so yeah, my story is complicated like that, you know. So but
boom rapper, your story is not gonna be peaceful.
You know what I'm saying?
Standard.
Yeah.
But that's what makes a great musician, right?
Yeah.
When you're not one thing and one thing only. And you have to have gone through quite a few things.
Yeah, man. You know, that's why I say, you know, from the village to the township to burbs, man, everywhere I've lived that life. You know?
So what can we expect in this album? Give me your top three, top of your head. Manando is one.
Yeah. And then we got The Plug. And then we have Bambelela. Yeah, it's a very motivational song. You know how I do. Yeah, man. There's just a lot. I love all those songs up in there, man. They all are, you know, they all have a strong message of their own.
Only on Massive Metro.